My name is Ashton Tolles. I am a junior at Yale, rising senior. I study political science. I'm getting my bachelor's and master's simultaneously. I was born and raised in Nashville, Tennessee, two parents, a younger sister, and two older brothers. I came to Yale from the South after being there my entire life and never going anywhere else. I had experienced some racial atrocities, seeing Confederate flags being waved. And so I had this perception that the North was different and that I wouldn't experience racism. I had certain conceptions of my identity before I came to Yale, and I was bound for a huge growth experience. My first semester, I witnessed two events on campus that dramatically changed how I viewed my Blackness and Blackness on campus and activism. First, there was the SAE incident, is what we call it. A Black group of women were trying to get into a party at SAE, and they were turned away by someone in the fraternity allegedly saying, "White girls only." Someone posted about it on Facebook, got so many likes, and I realized that there were other instances that had occurred before I came to campus that had been kicked under the rug. And then the second incident was related to a Yale faculty member email. It was essentially justifying wearing costumes that can appropriate culture or offend people who come from certain types of backgrounds. These two events had me very frightened and scared about how I should react. I was honestly so confused. I was angry, I was sad. I was disheartened. Powerful and strong people of color and Black women showed me how to respond. The March of Resilience was a march that was coordinated by Black women and other women of color in a way that would invoke change and catch the eye of the administration. It was so inspiring. I remember after the March of Resilience, I went up to my room and I cried. Before I came to Yale, I didn't always speak about race. I tried to avoid the topic, and I didn't want to have to think about it. And I had some internalized anti-Blackness that came from my upbringing. I was being awakened to the things that I tried to be asleep to. The tension that was occurring on campus did not dissipate the day after. The March of Resilience did not solve all the issues.
But yeah, and another incident happened too, literally 2.5 weeks ago.
This is so common.
Yeah.
Police get called on Black people
all the time. I think police don't get training on how to respond if someone incorrectly calls you because they're suspicious of a person of color.
Yeah.
They don't receive that type of training, and I think they should.
Yeah. I woke up yesterday, I finished my paper. Hmm. The first thing, at 5:57, I get on Twitter, and Yale was trending.
It is crazy to see things trending. Even like our first year, seeing us trending on Facebook and Twitter, that was wild. I guess like our first year, it was just highly traumatic.
Yeah.
Like, my sister sent me a picture of when I first got to Yale, and I was so excited.
Aww.
And like, look, straight hair and
yeah.
all. No more.
Didn't you do it all freshman year?
Yeah. And then like, I went natural that summer after. And
so I just stopped straightening my hair in high school. It was prom. That was like the last time I ever straightened my hair.
As a Black woman, you have your hair like in its natural state,
yeah.
and people don't compliment it.
Yeah.
The white community, and then you get it straightened. They're like, oh my God, you look so good. And that messes you up.
It doesn't make sense either. It just,
yeah.
It's sad.
So I met Nia on Old Campus, which is where all the first years stay.
These last couple of years, I was heavily involved with the Black Student Alliance. Usually they are the student group that like houses the Black community. So I went from being on the social events committee and like running those events to being the publicist, where I spent a lot of time trying to meet people in the Black community and like, meeting different sectors of it and figuring out how to get information throughout it. And then the next year I ended up being elected president, and that was a very exciting time.
And I see her doing so much labor for the Black community, like even in her presidency, that she didn't have to face any sort of like racial apocalypse, but a huge part of that is because of the labor that she was doing on campus. I think that it's important to make sure that the moment they step on campus, that students of color know that they belong.
There were lots of other issues to be brought up, including the renaming of Calhoun College. John C. Calhoun was not only a slave owner, but one of the leaders of political thought as to how to justify slavery. A lot of buildings were renamed after white men who were slave owners, and that's something that Yale has to reconcile with. But Calhoun is a residential college, and for students of color to say that my home is Calhoun is antithetical to their existence. And the renaming of Calhoun College to Hopper College was the best thing that could have happened.
We had a renaming of Calhoun ceremony. I spent a lot of time strategizing with the activists. How are we going to make this the action that we want it to be?
I will say that Yale did interact with the student community in a way that facilitated a lot more conversation than I saw among other Ivy League schools. Another grievance of the student body was we need more mental health specialists of color. Because as a Black individual, when you're trying to talk about trauma that you've experienced because of your race to a person who is not a person of color, that's really difficult. After my first semester at Yale, I took a different perspective on what I wanted to do and who I wanted to be and how I wanted my Black identity as a woman to fit into that. The Black community here is amazing and is a huge reason why I've been able to grow in the ways that I have because of the resources that we as Black people have on this campus. The AFM House is a home for Black people, a place where I can study, a place where I can consult people about my life and who I am.
My name is Shane Lloyd, and I am the assistant director of the Afro-American Cultural Center at Yale. We have a lot of different student groups affiliated with the house, over 35 in fact, that help advance the mission of the house, creating space specifically for Black students to bring their full selves with their various divergent experiences, whether it be around class, gender, sexuality, religious identity, or nationality. There is space for all of them here. We also see ourselves not just as a cultural center within Yale, but as a cultural center within New Haven.
The AFM House was founded in 1969 to foster a community of inclusion, but also to invite non-Black people and non-POC to experience the Black community and to be a part of that with us.
This is Edward Boucher, who was the first known Black graduate of Yale, who graduated with his PhD in physics in 1876. Here we have a series of different frames that have assorted photos from different decades of the Afro-American Cultural Center's history. What you'll see in each of the photos are events, defining moments, visits from dignitaries, town halls, dialogues, conversations. Some of the images here also reflect some of the activism from the fall of 2015.
Here we have some of the main organizers of the March of Resilience.
Yeah, lots of Black. So I met Ashton in her sophomore year, because that was my first year here at Yale, and she was performing in Shades at Yale, and I was just completely blown away by their performance, especially her voice. She has a very, very powerful voice. What brings me the greatest pride about working with students here at Yale is they're actually quite powerful and agentic. Really, it's just a matter of giving them a platform for them to exercise their voice.
At the student orientation program called Bulldog Days, I was able to see Shades for the first time. I saw a group that was me. It was full of people who looked like me, sang like me, moved like me. I was so excited the first time I saw Shades. I fell in love. Shades of Yale is a co-educational a cappella group, which was founded to sing music of the African diaspora and the African American tradition. So basically, music for Black people made by Black people, FUBU, for us by us. Shades embodies that mission.
I'm Kinsley McNulty, and I'm currently a senior at Yale. So, yeah.
I'm Miles Cameron, I'm a current junior. It's important to us to seek out places that might need kids who look like us who are at a university like Yale. And a lot of places that we've visited, like kids don't have role models who've gone on to pursue higher education or just know people who look like them. It's important to represent that this place is for everyone and they can achieve an education here as well, yeah.
We have a really good network of community spaces here. Even in times when I haven't necessarily felt at home in one space, I end up leaving to another space and I'm just like surrounded by love. And I think that that's really important to just have people, like no matter what, at the end of the day that you can talk to. There's such a mentality that like we can't be touched by issues of race because like we go to a place like Yale. Issues of race still happen here, like because they happen in the world at large. I ended up just like waking up not being able to sleep, and then I saw the video on her timeline recording her interactions with the person who called Yale police on her, as well as like the interactions with the police officers. And it's one of those things that like you see different news stories and like it already hits home. And then you see it in a building that's literally like just a block down from where you live.
The challenges and issues that are rife within our cities, communities will intersect at this institution. These students will end up going on to be world leaders and decision makers. So the kinds of experiences that they have at Yale end up becoming some of the really formative experiences that will inform their both professional and personal leadership style. So that's really an opportunity to be a mentor, partner, and advisor to students doing some of that powerful work. I was
by the river. That's why for me, admissions in a multicultural lens is so important, because often people think, oh, I don't belong there. Oh, I don't belong with those ivy walls and all those towers and architecture and big professors and big books and big money. Black people do belong at Yale. Other people of color do belong at Yale. And that's what I try to push for in admissions. When I first came to Yale, I wasn't completely sure of how my Black identity fit into everything. All these people interacting together pushed me and embraced me. I'm hoping that in the future, Yale can be viewed as, oh, I actually could go there. I see people who look like me there. I actually am represented there.